Henry Musoke, the Club Foot Program Coordinator, says many times parents are not aware of the availability of treatment in their localities. Without proper treatment, club foot can lead to lifelong disability and significantly affect a child's quality of life.
These children are born and they are living. Many times parents are not able to come to the hospital because they are not aware of the availability of treatment in their locality. At the same time, they have so many questions in their minds. You know, the hospital is usually separated from the community, and it's like the judge and the offender. So the purpose of our coming is to get closer to the communities, to help them understand that the club foot can be treated. It's not a curse, it's not witchcraft, it's not a disease that cannot be treated. It's the treatment is available within their locality, and it's free of charge.
The campaign, which is being done in collaboration with local health authorities and community leaders, aims to educate parents, caregivers, and healthcare providers about the importance of early diagnosis and treatment of club foot disease.
The somebody with a bad eye looked at somebody who's the mother with a pregnancy, or it is an identity of the family. So when we come to the community, talk to the communities about this, it's like bringing the treatment closer to them, to appreciate that this can be treated, to appreciate that we also care for them. It's not them looking for us to treat, but we are also looking for them to come and bring these children for treatment.
Through community outreach activities, the program seeks to dispel myths and misconceptions about the condition and highlight the availability of effective treatment options.
Nayetaba kumukintu kinu ekya club foot ekyokujanzaba rundi kumobilizinga abana bazairwa nobulema amaguru abiri garamaire akokuba twenda abana bangu tubakonyera bazaira abandi baina obutamanyi.
Research from the National Club Foot Program of Uganda indicates that 2,100 babies are born with the condition annually, but only 40% of this number are treated. Report by John Antusingwire for the news.